This is a complete how to zoom guide in Premiere Pro. So first, make sure your video clip is selected, then head over to effects controls. Then move this blue player to the position in the video where you want to start to zoom in. Now click on the stopwatch next to scale and position. This will now create these small objects called keyframes. These keyframes tell the video how it should look at each frame. So right now we tell the video that it should be set to the default settings. Now to zoom in, move forward to the point where you want the zoom to be complete, and then click and hold on a scale value and drag a mouse to left or right to zoom in or out. And we have now zoomed into the video, but our subject might not be centered. So to fix this, simply change the position values of the video. The value on the left represents the x-axis, and the value on the right is the y-axis. To change these values, click and hold with the mouse, and then move to left or right. These changes will automatically create these keyframes. If you now play back the video, you can see the zoom starts when the player reaches the first keyframes, the zoom ends when the blue player surpasses the second keyframes. So zoom basically happens in between these keyframes. That's because we have told the program how the video should look at each frame. To adjust the speed of the zoom, you can simply click and drag a mouse over the second keyframes to select them, then move these keyframes closer to the first part of the keyframes. This will give the video less time to zoom in and therefore speed the zoom up. If you now want to focus on a different person or object and still want to zoom in, then we can move forward to that point where we want to change the focus, then click on this keyframe icon next to scale and position. This will create keyframes for the current scale and position value. These keyframes tell Premiere that in between the last and the current keyframes, no zoom or position change will happen. Now to switch to a different object in the video, move forward in time and change the position values so the subject is in the screen. If needed, you can also adjust the scale value. We have now created a simple zoom in, then a pause between the second and third keyframes, and then a focus shift with a slight zoom out. Now to make a zoom out effect, we can once again move forward a bit and then click on these keyframes to tell Premiere to do nothing between the last and the current keyframes. Then move forward in time again. This time we can actually just click on this reset button next to position and scale, and it will automatically create keyframes and reset the values. We have now created this whole zoom sequence. To make this a bit more advanced, we can select all keyframes, then right click on one of them, go to temporal interpolation, and then click on ease in. Now right click on the keyframes again, this time choose ease out. This process makes the keyframes more smooth and therefore also the zoom effect. Subscribe.